Good morning, one and all. I am going to explain about connection oriented network today. Already I discussed with you what is the difference between the connection oriented network and connection less network. Once again, I repeat, connection oriented network, one virtual path gets established between the sender and receiver. Then only message is transmitted over the virtual path from sender to the receiver. So X.25 was the first public data network. It was deployed in 1970s. What they did, a computer first established a connection to a remote computer by placing a telephone call. That connection was given a connection number to be used with the data packets. So the data packet size was 128 bytes, header size was 3 bytes. And that header carries 12-bit connection number, but after that it was replaced by frame relay in 1980s without any flow control or error control mechanism. Why they didn't use the flow control or error control mechanism? Normally it is a connection oriented network. In connection oriented network, in which way the packets travels in the sender side, the exact order is maintained at the receiver side. After that, ATM network came to the picture. ATM stands for asynchronous transfer mode. Normally, every other communication, it was synchronous with the clock. But whenever we went for this ATM network, it was not synchronized with the clock. So that the name is asynchronous transfer mode or ATM network. Sometimes we tell that ATM virtual circuits also, because the connections are often called as virtual circuit. So we tell that ATM virtual circuit. It was designed in 1990s. It was much more successful than OSI reference model. The basic idea is to transmit small fixed size packets. That fixed size packets are called as cells. In other words, we tell as cell switching network. So part of the header is the connection identifier. That means each connection identifies that particular packet which has been transmitted from the sender to the receiver. Cell routing is done at the hardware so that high speed can be maintained. You see the example here. This is the sending host. This is a receiving host. So in between you see that this is our network, we tell as subnet, these are the routers. So first initially before the communication starts, a virtual path is established. On the top of the virtual path, the message is transmitted. The message is getting converted into number of packets, but all the packet size is constant in size. The packet size is 53 bytes. Out of 53 bytes, 48 bytes are used for the user data, 5 bytes are used for the header. So this is the ATM reference model. You see here in ATM model, ATM model is represented in 3 dimensional. One is user plane, then you go for this control plane, then another one is plane and layer management. Normally the user plane deals with data transport, flow control and error control. Control plane deals with connection management. Then layer and plane management deals with the resource management and interlayer coordination. You see the down part, this one, there are 3 layers are there. One is physical layer, one is ATM layer, another one is ATM adaptation layer. In this physical layer, again is divided into 2 parts. One is PMD, physical medium dependent sublayer. Another one is TC, transmission convergence sublayer. Then we are going for ATM layer. Again we are going for ATM adaptation layer. Again ATM adaptation layer is divided into 2 parts. One is CS, another one is SAR. CS means convergence sublayer, SAR means segmentation and reassembly sublayer. So in the next slide, I will explain about the functionality of each layer. So you see that this is the physical layer, this is the ATM layer, this is the AL layer, this is the ATM reference model. So this side we have put it here, OSI reference model. So that comparison, I can explain you how ATM reference model is a different with respect to OSI reference model. So you see that the physical layer, again it is divided into two parts. One is PMD, another one is the TC. This physical medium dependent layer deals with the physical layer. It provides the interfaces to the cable. So it takes care of the bead timing. So exactly whatever it is done in the physical layer of OSI layer. So it is the physical layer of OSI reference rail layer deals with the raw bits. So how many ports you can represent for one, how many ports you can represent for zero. All these are taken care by the physical layer in the OSI model. So similarly, in the PMD, bit timing is maintained by the PMD layer. So in the TC layer, you see that TC layer, transmission convergence sub layer, takes care of the cell generation. So cell generation, frame generation, header checksum calculation, so packing, unpacking of cells, all are done by the TC layer. Then we are going for the ATM layer. So ATM layer, you see here, this is similar to the network layer and top part of the data link layer. In the OSI layer, whatever functionality is there with respect to OSI layer, ATM layer does that same work. So flow control, cell header generation, extraction, virtual circuit path management, cell multiplexing, demultiplexing, all are done by the ATM layer. So again, we are going for ATM adaptation layer. So whatever functionality is done by the network layer and transport layer, this functionality is done by the AL layer, ATM adaptation layer. So this AL layer is divided into two parts. One is CS, one is convergence of layer, another one segmentation and reassembly and layer. So what happens here? This CS layer provides services according to the different applications. SAR layer is provide the is goes for segmentation and reassembly. What is the meaning of that? Whenever the cells are transmitted from the sender and the receiver, so in the which order it is transmitted from the sender and the receiver, in the receiver side, just push them back to retrieve the original information. So this is all about the ATM reference model. So this is the comparison ATM reference model with respect to OSI layer and very details whatever they have done. So individual layer functionality are given is given here. So this is all about the ATM network.